Amen and amen and amen. Hallelujah. Children of God, this morning we have a word from the Lord, a word of life, a word that will make us to be who we need to be in life. Praise Master Jesus. Without wasting any time, the topic before this one says the indescribable glory of heaven. The indescribable glory of heaven. Brothers and sisters, I've come to understand, no matter you try to describe the glory of heaven, it's like trying to describe God Himself. The more you think you know God, the more you don't know Him. The more you think you know heaven, the more you know nothing. Heaven is a place that nothing on earth can be used to describe. No amount of lighting on earth you will light that will describe the glory of heaven. That will describe the glory that many people are missing every day. Heaven is a place that not even the mouth can describe the glory in it. Every man in heaven is a glory. Every flower in heaven is a glory. Anything that is called a thing in heaven is a glory. If you want to describe the flower in heaven, it's indescribable. If you want to describe the radiance of that radiates in the life of the saint in heaven, it's indescribable. If you want to describe the throne of Papa in heaven, is unmeasurable. So, this morning, I have been mandated to let us know that heaven is a place we shouldn't by any means miss, either by carelessness or by voluntarily refusing to go there. Because the glory are waiting for you. And the Bible says that those who enter hell will be turned into hell. Every saint that enter heaven are turned into heaven. Every saint that enter the glory of heaven are turned into glory. I was made to understand last night, those in heaven do not pray for the glory of God again. Immediately you cross the gate of heaven, you are now glory yourself. The glory of the Father become you. Everything that radiates in the life of the Son of God become you. The word that says, I in you, you in me, and I in my Father is made complete in heaven. If you want to truly see what happened in I in you, you in me in my Father, that the Bible says in John chapter 6 from verse 52, get to heaven. You will see the completion of that word. Praise Master Jesus. Everything in heaven is heaven. Every set in heaven are heaven. That's why some people are evil, eager to die for God to enter there. Some people are ready to do everything by anything to enter that glory. Just as Jesus Christ did everything in everything to enter that glory. Praise Master Jesus. So I'm here to tell myself, to tell yourself, whatever that is trying to distract you or distract me from that glory should be pushed aside. Praise Master Jesus. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter number 11, Hebrews chapter number 11, verse 13, let me start from 12 to 15. Praise Father Jesus. 12 to 16. Say, therefore, sprang there even of one, and him as God as good are dead. So many are the stars of the sky in multitude, and as the sand which by the sea shore innumerable. These all died in faith, not having received the promises, by having seen them afar off, and were persuaded of them, and embraced them, and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on the earth. For they that say such things declare plainly that they seek a country. Declare plainly that they seek a country. Praise Master Jesus. That they seek a country. And true, verse 15, and true, truly, if they had been mindful of that country, from where they came out, they might have had opportunity to have returned. Verse 16. But now, they desire a better country, that is an heavenly, wherefore God is not ashamed to be called their God, for he hath prepared for them a city. That's why I love the song that says, we are marching through thy city, where the builder maker is God. We are marching to the city where the builder maker is God. Except the Lord build the city, neither builder builded it. Except the Lord watch a city, neither watch it in vain. The Bible says these people had a promise of seeing a place called Jericho or whatever the name might be on earth here. The Bible, they desire to see this place. They desire this country. But nevertheless, they had a better country in mind. Abraham desired this place called Jericho. Jacob desired it. The 12 tribe of Judah that formed the Israel today desired it. But they died without seeing it. Why? Because even if they died without seeing it, they were not bothered. Why? Because the Bible, they seek a better country. They knew within them there is a better country than the country that the Lord promised them on earth here. They knew no matter how Germany is beautiful, no matter how Ireland is beautiful, no matter the benefits you are receiving in Ireland as a woman that gave birth or whatever benefit you are receiving, is nothing to be compared to the country we are going to. The Bible says they all died in faith, having received the promises, but having seen afar, they died and they were persuaded that there is a better country to be received. And the Bible says it is a city prepared for them by God. Heaven is called a city. No matter how heaven is bigger than 400 of earth, but yet it's called a city because it is a city of God. Are you prepared to live in that city? The city that Abraham desired and he saw it, he entered. The city that Jacob desired, Isaac desired. He forgot about every other city on earth here. And today, it's happily happy in that city. Are you prepared to enter that city that Jacob told the children about? Though, no matter what happened on earth here, he forgot the city, the land that that God promised their father here. And said, no, I can foresee a better city waiting for me. The city of God, the city of life, the city that the king is the builder, a city that I don't need to contend again with the Amorites, with the Egyptians, with all the enemies around here. I better forgot the city of that is promised to me on earth here and focus on that city. I better forgot all the cars that was prophesied about to me here and face the chariot I will see over there. I better forget all the gold, all the silver, all the houses, all the whatever it is on this earth that will pass away and focus on that city. The Bible says, and they entered the city because they were not mindful of the country they are coming from. They are not mindful of the country that was promised them on earth here. How are you eager? How are you enthusiastically waiting for that city? How are you eager to clean yourself to make sure you enter that city? Because the Bible says, nothing defiling, nothing sinned shall enter that city. It's a pure, holy, and clean city of God. It's a city that God himself is the architect, is the builder, is the maker, and nothing unclean is found in him. The Bible says, don't worry, I am coming for you. The Bible says in John chapter 4, verse 1 to 3, let not your heart be troubled. Let not your heart be worried. Let not your heart be troubled. For I am coming back for you. John chapter 4, praise the Lord. I'm missing something here. John chapter 14. Amen. John chapter 14. From verse 1. Let me go there. John 14. From verse 1. Say, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God. The God that the Abrahams believe. The God that Isaac believed. The God that Jacob believed. The God that the Israelites of old believed. And they entered the city. They believe it. Believe also in me, the Messiah, the King of Kings, the first son of from the dead. Believe me. In my Father's house are many mansions. On earth here, we are struggling for two flats. On earth here, we are struggling for our apartment. We are struggling for four flats. If I don't build four flats, I will die. I have to build four flats for my parents. If I don't build, hey, what are you doing? It's not worth dying for. The Bible says in heaven, mansions are given out for free. What my father gave out in heaven is mansions, not just two bedroom flats that people are there. When I see people struggling after these things, it marvels me because you are not in the siege what you are about to miss. So in my Father's house are many mansions. In my Father's house, not evil city now, not evil country. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go and prepare you a place. I'm going to prepare a mansion for you. Our Father is not a joker. When he says it, he does it. So you don't need to kill yourself over all these kunye houses we are seeing here. No matter the cattle on earth here, it's not to be compared with a pillar in heaven. A pillar in heaven is what the highest castle or pinnacle on earth here. Yeah, if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again. Take notice, say, I will come again. Jesus is coming again, and his coming is now. I will come again and receive you into myself, unto myself. That where I am, there you will be also. Are you ready to be there? Heaven is a place of people for a people that are ready for it. Nobody enter heaven by mistake. Nobody enter heaven by chance. You enter heaven by preparation. Powerful preparation prevent poor performance. You merit it. What is the merit? By accepting the owner of heaven as your Lord and personal Savior. Jesus Christ must be the Lord of your life. Not just only your personal Savior, he must be the Lord of your life. He must be the determinant of everything you do. Praise Master Jesus. Heaven is too wonderful to be missed. And remember, whoever that miss heaven have another dwelling place, which you and I know. We speak about it every day here. If you miss heaven, you will not miss the other place. Praise Master Jesus. But today I'm mandated to talk about this place called Wonderful Place Heaven. The Bible says in the book of Revelation chapter 22. Revelation 22, verses 1 to 5. And he showed me a pure river of water. Hey, there's no blood stain in that river. Nothing is, no sewage that flow in there. No dirty thing from Ajegunle that flow into the river. No dirty thing from companies that flow in there. So he showed me a pure river. Our brother John was speaking here. Pure river of life. You and I will see it also and will dwell there in the name of Jesus Christ. Yesterday night, after I did some worship, I was imagining some things. And later, my father was telling me, he said, some people are saying they have not seen heaven. I wish they see heaven. Say, let them relax. Study my word and live after my word. Say, it's a place they will dwell for eternity. Say, the bed you will sleep in the night, you don't rush over it. It's already there for you. All you need to do is to dress the bed well. Dress the bed as you want to sleep on it. Say, tell my children, until I reveal myself to him or her, they will not do the work. They will not believe what I'm saying. Even when my word is saying it. Say, tell them to believe in my word. Tell my children to believe heaven exists. Because it's a place they will forever live. As far as there is death, there's heaven. As far as there is death, there's hell. Let them, even though I have not shown them in their dream, tell them to believe that it exists. Because if they believe it, they will get it and they will live in it. Praise Master Jesus. Say, I saw a pure river of life, clear as crystal. We know why crystal is it's a sparkling thing. Proceeding out of the throne of God and of the Lamb. In the midst of the streets of it and of either side of the river, were there the tree of life, which bear 12 manner of fruit, and yield her fruit every month. Every month. It starts producing from the first day to the last day. It's always producing the fruit of life. Everything in heaven is of life. The river of life. The fruit of life. Everything is of life. There's no death in heaven, sister. Once you get in there, you will forever remain there, forever enjoy it. That's why I say, don't miss it. He bear 12 manner of fruit, representing the 12 tribes of Israel, and yield her fruit every month. And the leaf of the tree were for the healing of the nation. Everybody there are already healed. It's an automatic healing. Once you enter heaven, the first thing they do, they train you up. They give you that water of life to drink. And they make sure you eat out of that fruit of life. And once you eat it, you are forever healed forever. No more sickness, no more death, no more sorrow, no more pain over there. And there shall be no more curse. Curse means there shall be no room for problem, for misfortunes, for all these things that befall men. There will be no more room for them again in your life, if and only if you enter there. Which I know everybody on this mountain, we are members of heaven, and we always enter there in the name of Jesus Christ. And there shall be no more curse, but the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it, and his servant shall serve him. Praise Master Jesus. And there shall be no more night there. And they need no candle. There is need of no candle in that place called the wonderful city. Neither light of the sun, for the Lord God giveth them light, and they shall reign forever and ever and ever and ever. Hey, no matter how poor you are on earth here, my sister, don't worry. Even though nobody knows you here, you shall be known shortly, Sister Susan. It doesn't matter if Obama knows you, who is Obama to recognize you? Who is that man you are saying, let me do everything about me for this man to know me? Hey, it's not worth it. Seek for heaven to know you. Seek for the Son of Man to recognize you. Seek for God to know you in that even your quiet environment. Because a time is coming, you shall reign and reign and reign and reign as a queen, as a king, in your own domain in heaven. Everything in heaven belongs to you. Hey, the Bible says in Revelation chapter 21, Revelation 21, from verse 3 to 5. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them, and be their God. Hey, are you not happy to be a part of this? Will you not be happy to be a part of such people who God is their God and they are the people of God? And the Bible says in verse 4, and God shall wipe away all their tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. Look for documents, will be passed away. Look for a child, we pass away. Husband, you don't need any fleshy husband there. God, Jesus Christ shall be your husband. No more divorce there. No more pain there. No more whooping there. No more sickness. No more typhoid. No matter the pain you are going through now, there shall be no more there. No more oppression of demon. Depression, no more casting out demon there. No more healing there. Hey, apostle, I'm sick. It's no more there. Would you want to go there? And the other place is a typical 100% opposite of this place we are talking about now, which nobody should dare to go. Can't you understand? God shall wipe away all their tears. A time is coming. You'll be in a place that tears is not allowed. No matter you try. If you try to shed tears, joy will be coming out. If you try to cry, you see yourself laughing. You see yourself rejoicing. You see yourself entertaining life over there. No room of tears. not thinking of pain over there. And he that sat on, verse 5, I'm reading Revelation 3, 21, verse 5. And he that sat on the throne said, behold, I make all things new. For my daughter Ahimema, behold, I make all things new. Matu Brakandabu. And he said unto me, write, for this word are true and faithful. Sister Susan, it will come to pass. Those who are dead already are already facing what we are preaching now. If they're in hell, they are already facing the danger of hell. If they're in heaven, they are already facing the beauty of heaven. Say, it is faithful and truth. And he said unto me, it is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is a test of the fountain of the water of life freely. Verse 7. He that overcometh shall inherit. Is there a place you just desire without working for? Say, he that overcometh shall enter therein, shall inherit it, all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. My brothers and sisters, he that overcometh, that thing you are going through, you must overcome it for you to be a part of this kingdom. All these things we are telling you, you must strive hard to make sure you overcome, because the grace to overcome is given to you. Don't allow your husband to take you to the other side of eternity. Don't allow, I have not bought a car, to take you to the other side of eternity. Don't allow, I have not built a house in my country. Nobody knows I have traveled for the past 14 years. Nobody even knows in my country that if I've traveled, it doesn't matter. Nobody talking about me. By now, I know some people I travel the same time with. They have gotten houses. I'm not saying it's not good to build a house. It's good. But don't build a house in expense of your salvation. Don't sell your salvation to build your house. Else, you forever regret doing what you have done. The Bible says, he that overcome fornication, overcome lies, overcome that sin you are committing right now, overcome that sin you are about to commit today, he that overcometh shall inherit all things, inherit the kingdom of God. But if you read verse 8, it says, but the fearful, you that are afraid of your husband to do the right thing, you that are afraid of your pastor to do the right thing. If I leave the church now, I'm finished. You will be finished very soon. And if I say, tell my husband, I will not be following him to this place, which I know is a place of, according to my brother, Apostle Peace, it's a secular meeting. It's just a place where we come every Sunday, gather and dance to the devil. You know it. But because of you are afraid of your husband, it's not to withdraw from it. And pray and say, Father, I want my husband to follow me to also do what I'm doing. You are following him. I tell you, you will follow him to the other side of eternity. There are two ways of eternity. You must enter one. It is under mandatory. It is mandatory that you must inherit one side of eternity. But today I'm mandated to speak about the one that the Lord is expecting us. Two people are expecting us in different part of eternity. Satan is expecting some people, which I and you must not go. And our Father is expecting us in another side of eternity, which is called heaven. The other one, if you are forgotten, is called hell of fire. And anyone that enters there is turned into fire. Hell is not a hidden name on this mountain. We all know, even my children, little divine. Say, hey, I'm not going. Hey, I'm not going. Heifun, Heifun. I said, yes, my son, Heifun, we are going to. If divine, a little child of 2 years can know what's heaven and hell. If someone do anything that is wrong, he says, someone, you go to hell. Someone says, no. Mm-mm. Divine, no. Hell, fire, no. Heaven, okay, heaven. I'll just be smiling and say, hey, see children, they already know what's called heaven or hell. But you are busy teaching your children how to play computer game. You are busy teaching them how to do all those nonsense. Instead of you to show them the difference between the two eternity. You think you're helping them. You think you are a good father. You are better than me, father. No problem. When you have to go, you should watch television. And you are, as you go away, they put cartoon. Satan is entering them. You are a caring mother. You're a caring father. When you go out, you buy wonderful cartoon CD for them. Or wonderful toy. Toy that can be talking to them. When they come, them and toy will be speaking language that you don't understand. But I've chosen them to make sure my children know what I know. At the early age, I try to build heaven and hell in their mind. I showed them the picture of hell. My children, all liars come. You see this place that is burning, all liars go there. No. Heaven. If you say heaven, you must respect mother. Obey your father and your mother. Divine, you must not curse Samuel because Samuel is senior to you. If you want to go heaven, you must obey your senior. When I say Samuel, bring me water, you run and give me, because Bible says, children, obey your parents in the Lord. Ephesians 6 verse 1. For this is right. Honor your father and your mother, that it may be well with you. All those things they know in their head already. Because it's a prerequisite to enter the heaven you are talking about here. Praise Master Jesus. The Bible in verse 8. But the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and soothsayers. All these places have been read over and over again. Apostle Peace, Apostle Tangle, all the apostles of this ministry, they have preached over and over again. That is why I have no reason to miss heaven. You have no reason to miss heaven. That's why I try by all means not to be afraid of Sister Susan. No matter who she is, I try by all means to build a faith in me not to be afraid of Sister Doris or Sister Cynthia or whoever you think you are. There's nothing you will do, be a billionaire today, I will not be afraid of your money. I will tell you the truth. Praise Master Jesus. Your money cannot change my mouth anymore because I have a controller who have trillions and trillions uncountable of what you think you have. Do you know what? If I honor you and forsake my father, if you die tomorrow, I don't see you anymore, and it blow the trumpet, you cannot help me. So why should I obey you and disobey somebody who I will stand before tomorrow? The fearful and the unbelieving. If you don't believe there's heaven, I pity you. If you don't believe the gospel we are preaching on this mountain, before we preach any gospel here, we scrutinize it. We search ourselves if we should preach it. And we say, yes, we preach it. And everything we are saying here is nothing but the truth. And the Bible says, you cannot do anything against but for the truth. Praise Master Jesus. The fornicators, the idolaters, all liars, all soothsayers, all witch, whatever that is defiling, cannot enter into the city we'll be talking about. And I know it is the desire for every one of us to enter that city. By the grace of God, we will enter it in the name of Jesus Christ. I have two verses to preach, to go, and we will close. The Bible says, in the same, I go to my brother, professor, I have no leisure of time. Praise Master Jesus. In Revelation chapter 21, verse 22 to 27, I just read through. And it says, and I saw no temple therein, for the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb are the temple of it. We are talking about that place, wonderful place, that city called heaven. And I saw no temple therein. So people are saying, you always talk about hell. Relax your mind now and absorb heaven. If you cannot do the right thing because of hell, do it now because of heaven. If you are running away from God because of hell, run to Him now because of heaven. Because you cannot afford to meet the two. One must wait for you. And I saw no temple therein, for the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb, which is Jesus Christ, the Lamb that was slain for you and I, at the temple of it. And the city had no need of the sun, neither of the moon, to shine in it. For the glory of God did lighten it, and the Lamb is the light thereof. What a wonderful place. And the nations of them which are saved shall walk in the light of it. The nations, you and I, who are saved, shall walk in that light of it. And the kings of the earth do bring their glory and honor into it. And the gate of it shall not be shut at all by day. The gate is always open. You know why? Because there are no thief, no highway robbers, no ISIS, or what they call them, no Boko Haram in that place, no suicide bombers in that place. Hallelujah. And the gate of it shall not be shut at all by day, for there shall be no need, for there shall be no night there. And the day shall bring the glory and honor of the nation unto it. And there shall in no wise enter there into it anything that defileth. Praise Master Jesus. Nothing defiling shall enter into it. So there is a prerequisite of entering into that wonderful city we're talking about. Praise Master Jesus. Amen. I come again, verse 27. And there shall in no wise enter into it anything that defileth, neither whosoever walketh abomination or maketh a lie, but they which are written in the Lamb Book of Life. Is your name in the Book of Life? Are you written in the Book of Life? Is your name written there? The only those that their names are written in the Book of Life shall be found there. Those who have accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as their Lord and personal Savior. Those who have decided to look at this world as nothing. Those who have decided to look at anything that is called something on earth as nothing. To enter into that city called the city of God, heaven. Praise Master Jesus. Once again, I don't have leisure of time. When you get home, read Revelation chapter 7, verse 9 to 16. And 1 Peter 3, 7 to 14. Revelation 7, 9 to 17, and 1 Peter 3, from 7 to 12 to 14 for more enlightenment about heaven. As I've said before, heaven is indescribable place. No matter what I say to you now, it is nothing to be compared to what you shall see when you enter there. So, ask yourself this morning, is my name in the book of life? Or, my name was there some time ago. Has this not been wiped away because of my sin? Am I still in that book of heaven? If you know you are not sure of it, this is the hour to reconcile back to the Lord. And if you know you are here, you are not born again, the hour has come to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, so that you will not go to hell, so that you will make heaven. Praise Master Jesus. Are you under the sound of my voice? And you are not born again. You have seen a little description of heaven. And you are not ready to miss it. Brothers and sisters, the hour has come to submit to our Father. But it's only through Him we can enter that city called the city of God, heaven. Are you here? You want to submit to the Lord Jesus Christ? Maybe you heard about hell. Hell could not move you to submit. Now, you have heard about heaven now. Heaven should move you to submit to the Lord. Are you here? You are not born again. Or maybe you are watching me wherever, all over the world. You want to submit to the Lord Jesus Christ. Say, I am here. Or maybe you are not sure of your name in the book of life. You want to reconcile. There is a sin in your life, you know, you have not been able to deal with. The grace is sufficient for you and I right now. Say, I am here also. I have. God bless you. God bless you. I have about 4 people that say I'm here. God bless you. Which one is it? I want to be born again, or I want to reconcile, or I want the Lord to search me out. Which one are you? I know that English is a sweet English. Search me out. Hallelujah. I know everybody will love that English. God, search me out. It's not hard. Amen. And this morning, the Holy Ghost, who has the power to search us out, even I myself that I preach the gospel, I also want the Lord to what? Search me out. Until we enter there, we still need to be searched out every day. Praise the Lord. So I want every one of us, including the preacher this morning, who preached about it, to go on his knee, on our knees, to say, Daddy, I'm trying. But I don't think my try is enough. Check me out and see if there's any way I need to still do more. Help me to do it so that I will not miss that place called heaven. Let us pray. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, this yesterday, the mighty Redeemer, you have heard your word this morning. Father, on my knees, O Lord, I pray, Lord, Father, I've heard your word. Father, I pray, Lord Jesus, your mercy, Father, search me, Lord, from my inside to my outside, O God. I don't want to be a signboard, O God. I don't want to be just a preacher. Father, I want to be a preacher and a practicer. Father, I want to enter that holy city that you have used my mouth to preach about this morning. Father, I don't want to miss to God. Lord Jesus, search me.